overall stressful.
And I'm eating in the bathroom.
Gonna condense, gonna filter, gonna... Not yap.
Is it whipping?
Patience. Nathan, you're barely touching the cream.
Hello, hi, good morning, people. It's Saturday, and a very dirty mirror. This is the fit. We got this vintage leather trench in like a chocolate brown. I don't know if you can see that. Navy sweater, little white shirt peeking out, white jeans, and our legacy necklace there. Going to the city, getting a haircut, and meeting a friend from San Francisco. So excited. Gonna bop around town. It's gonna be a good one. And bag of the day is this, where is this from? Koss. The coveted Koss crossbody. I'm in my Britney Bathgate era. Yes, we're serving today. Let's go. I'm late, as always. We just got a haircut, and now I need to go buy a gift for my friend. So we're gonna go to Hanamdong to Nonfiction, pick up a hand cream set. It's the default gift, everybody loves it. And then maybe check out a museum because my friend is hungover. So yeah, gonna give him some time. Yeah, let's go.
Thank you.
We're at the hotel. Do we want a quick room tour? This is the bathroom. Shower. Toilet. Little closet. There's the bed. And a little view.
It's aight.
TV 2.
Quite exceptional lighting. I like this. This is a really nice, like, easy budget hotel. It's not bad. In Ixadong, it's pretty nice. Not gonna lie. Sorry if you can hear, there's like this weird whistling noise, like an ongoing kettle. I don't know what it is, so sorry if you hear that. I'll try to speak loud. I am pooped. Pooped. Got the haircut. Did some art, got the gift. I'm a good gift giver. I also found these Pokemon masks. They're pretty great. Look at that, super adorable. Gonna sneak these into the nonfiction bag. We got the hand lotion set for the friendo. I'm going to Hongdae to drink. But I don't even know any like good bars in Hongdae. I don't hang out in that area enough. So we gotta do some research and figure out an answer quick. Okay, what to say? Yeah, went to nonfiction and then afterwards, I didn't realize, but I spent quite a lot of time at the Lyeong Museum, which I haven't been to in like, I don't think ever since I even arrived in Korea. Last time I went was like 2017. And of course, I went on a day where their permanent exhibition on the basement floor, where their contemporary art is being, you know, new installs. So we didn't see any of that, but we saw a very good exhibition on sort of the trauma work that goes on into imagining a future and where art lies in the future. Lots of sculptural work mixed with digital media, and interesting, some artists from around the world as well as Korean artists. And yeah, it was interesting. If you're ever in the Hanamdong area, definitely recommend that. And then I'm here. Gonna chillax. I got some convenience store food. Do you wanna see? Look at this double katsu. It's literally a burrito. A double katsu kimbap. Massive. Shall we do a taste test? I always feel weird about eating on screen, but water, of course, because I am dehydrated. It is time to take a disco nap. You feel? Not quite sure if I'm doing an all-nighter. Don't think I should. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know. But I'm gonna put this in my mouth. Taste test. First bite of the day, here we go. Mm-hmm. That's double, all right. Bookish updates. We are reading Weight of the Earth, the tape journals of David Wonarovich. Sorry, I keep fucking up his name. Wonarovich. New York artist, 70s and 80s. These are his tape journals. So he did this thing where he had a diary, but it was on tape, only for himself. And yeah, transcribed in this book. Though I feel like I would get a lot more out of the tapes if it was like an audiobook. I wonder if there's an audiobook. But found out about this artist, Lizzie Hadfield. Love her. From the UK. She's got great style. She's like, yeah, I like her and Brittany Bathgate.
I really like Lizzie's content because it's both like London content and like New York content because she lives in both cities, and I just think that's wonderful. I wish I had that. But yeah, found out about this artist from her, decided to pick this up, and yeah, it's really intimate. He died of AIDS, and these were sort of like his journal entries a little bit before that time, and him just like being obsessed with this guy named Bill. And it just feels so intimate, as if he's like in my head, or like my best friend confessing something and I'm like listening intently. I'm really liking it. Tiny books only until the end of December because I'm trying to push my reading count. But yeah, enjoying that. I also brought with me Maud Martha. I started it. Yeah, was thinking I might finish this, maybe, and then had this as a backup book. Just started though, very poetic. Gwendolyn Brooks, I think she's known as a poet, but this is poetry. I'm gonna claim it as poetry. They're little vignettes split up into chapters of this woman named Maud Martha, and it's delicious. The prose is wonderful. So we're doing that. Today, I feel like is the last day of fall, it feels like. I was walking through the streets, lots of people out, enjoying the great outdoors before it gets too cold. And there's like this one last ginkgo tree that was still yellow. It was really pretty because it was like the only ginkgo tree on the street. Loud and proud and yellow, still standing strong and still maintaining its leaves. Like holding on to like the last glimmers of fall. I really like fall in Korea. If anyone ever goes to Korea, fall is like perfect. It's literally, the weather's perfect. It's warm enough, yet cool enough for like blazers and like a light trench. It's just, ugh. Vibes, immaculate. Yeah, I wanna take a disco nap. Anybody feel that? Maybe get some work done? I don't know. Until I meet my friends at like 8 at night. And then still trying to figure out what I'm doing tomorrow. But I just wanna chillax. I feel like the next couple of weeks are just gonna be stressful because, you know, end of the year stuff. Just like work and accumulating Christmas gifts and meeting people, and I have like relatives coming in. It's just overall stressful. And I just bought my ticket back to America, so it's like I don't wanna spend a bunch of money either, but I spent money today. You know, you wanna see what I bought from the museum? These German pens. Ugh, I don't. Okay, the acoustics in the museum store were a lot better and it made it a satisfying click. But these, I don't know. They're so slick and soft. Basic ballpoint. I don't know, there's just something satisfying about them. I love them. I bought two. Why am I spending money on pens? I already have a bunch of pens. Anyway, I don't want this to go on for so long because I just edited. If anyone wants to know the time frame of how I edit these things, I just finished uploading the 45-minute vlog, whatever it is, but I think it's by far the longest vlog I have. I think because it was like a 3-day weekend. Nevertheless, that, who's gonna sit through 40 minutes of that shit? That's a lot. Yeah, so I just finished uploading that and I realized I think I talk way too much. So, I'm gonna condense, gonna filter, gonna. Not yap. I don't wanna yap. I want to. I have you propped up on this thing and then like directly outside's the window. I wonder if anyone's like watching me and is like, what the fuck is that guy doing? But yeah, I talk too much and that's probably why I exhaust people. So I'm done. Be well, do good work, keep in touch.
I think we were blessed with the easiest one. He got his first vaccine this morning, so our...
Thank you. It's about to happen.
Just keep yelling for music. I'm gonna slide myself.
And the gays are just like, where?
This is a bathroom. This is a bathroom. This is insane. I have you know, it is 3 a.m. in Hongdae. 3 a.m. in Hongdae. Reporting live. This is insane. Hi. I just got back. It's 5 a.m. I have a kimbap. And I'm eating in the bathroom because it's the only mirror. Hey y'all, Hoodie Sunday. I am running late. No, we're actually on time, which is late. Meeting a friend for brunch, and then I think I'm meeting my other friends for Kwajang Sijang. I think I mentioned that before, but it's like the biggest traditional market in Seoul. And yeah, and then do some shopping, I think. Play tour guide. Cafe hop, maybe. Yeah. Checking out. Love this hotel. Let's go.
One more time for the vlog.